I was just making a joke to my friend Chuck before the show started about this is a wedding song. It's something that I concocted the morning before a wedding that I got invited to play. And I have a really poor batting average when it comes to weddings staying together that I've played at. So I'm probably not the right person to bless your wedding. If you're looking for somebody, I would recommend maybe looking elsewhere. Or maybe it's just a statement of the about the times that we're in. I'm not sure. But anyway, this is Kate's Cove Suite. It's named after a state park in East Tennessee up in the Great Smoky Mountains.
Thank you.
afraid this mic's a little feedbacky here. Getting some low frequency doom sounds, and that's not what I'm going for right now. I have in the past gone for that kind of sound. Well, this next song I'm going to play is called The Groundhog, and it is about a family of groundhogs, or a couple of groundhogs that decided to have a family underneath my house. And groundhogs can do a lot of damage to your foundation, so people kept telling me I should shoot the groundhogs, and I didn't really want to because I thought they were cute, and I wrote a theme song for them instead of shooting them. And that may be ill-advised if my house collapses and everybody will know why. Do you even have groundhogs in California? I just realized I don't know that. I know we have marmots up in the Rocky Mountains. There are lots of similar creatures, but they're not the same. Can anyone tell me if there are groundhogs here? I'm very curious now.
There are an exit.
I don't know.
We do.
I think there are.
Yeah. I think so.
Less of a problem, generally.
Well,
we have them in Arizona. We have them here.
Yeah. Well, this is about a mysterious exotic creature from the far east of the United States. It's got little teeth. They're kind of big teeth like a mouse. Never mind. I'm just going to play the song.
Thank you.
This next one's called Before the Lord. This is from a Psalm something or other. I can't remember which one it is, but it's, I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living, which is carved onto a tombstone in an old cemetery down the road from where I live. And I just thought that was kind of striking. And I wrote a song that's about being in the cemetery and then kind of going back out into the land of the living, I guess. But to get to the cemetery, there's a creek that you have to go across, and probably that creek will come up again in another one of my songs, but it's called Cub Creek. I'm sure everyone is intimately familiar with my catalog of work. But that pops up a lot, and has popped up a lot. If you ever see Cub Creek or Cub Mountain or any number of other things, I don't even remember how many songs I have called that. I don't expect you to know. All right. Made such an old man noise when I went to get this capo. I'm getting entirely too old. My fingers are sweating and my fingertips are trying to come off. That's terrible. I shouldn't have admitted that. Need to get some adhesive or something here. Anyway, this next song is called Swannanoa. It's named after a river and a community in North Carolina that I just thought was a pretty word. There isn't a terribly deep story to it. I just happened to be visiting a friend near there when I had this melody bouncing around in my head.
Thank you.
increase my level of professionalism on this tour and bring some guitar stands with me instead of just having my guitars laying around. And I got these guitar stands thinking surely there can't be that much of a difference between a cheap guitar stand and a less cheap guitar stand. And the first night of the tour, there's some sharp part, I still don't even know what it was, that cut my thumb when I tried to adjust the guitar stand. And now the little part, there's some part of it that just falls off all the time. These are terrible guitar stands. So I think you might ought to invest in something a little bit better, if you can. This next song is called The Emerald City. This is it's a reference to, I think it's just the introduction maybe of a book by Henri Corbin. His name looks like Henry Corbin, but he is French. So it's Henri Corbin. He was kind of an Iranologist, but he did a lot of works on Islamic mysticism. And the Emerald City is a reference to something that pops up in the works of some Muslim mystic poets or theologians, thinkers, as a kind of heavenly realm that they've ascended to. And I'm not sure that we're here in that heavenly realm. Here in Oakland, California, little did anybody know that that's where we go when we die. Trying to get these things to stay on. I've been practicing aleatoric composing when there are noisy environments, which is just for my own benefit. I don't think it makes me a brilliant artist or something, but if I'm playing and there's a bar where people are chattering or if there's sound going on, I like to kind of dissolve into it and come back out of it a little bit or try to wonder if anybody will ever notice it. Sometimes I'll hear somebody who's being particularly loud and I'll start kind of making fun of them a little bit with my guitar, trying to emulate, hey, that's what you sound like, can you tell? And I don't think anybody can tell, they just keep doing what they're doing. And anyway, this is Emerald City.
Thank you.
was playing that just then, I was thinking that there's a big contrast between a song about some heavenly realm and medieval Islamic mysticism and a song about groundhogs. But I don't think that, I don't want to stay with that. I think that there's something every bit as divine, probably more divine, about a family of groundhogs as anything else. Maybe we need to realize that. And the sooner we realize that, the better it'll be for us and for everything else too. That's my profound statement for the night, I think. That seemed more profound in my head when I was playing that. I had a thing called a snark. Do you know what a snark is? The little headstock tuner. That's such a bad name for a device, and it broke. They're just not trustworthy anyway, and you shouldn't expect something called a snark to be trustworthy. So that's why I'm sitting here having to tune by ear. Right there, so that's close enough. All right, this one's called Tracks in the Snow, which is about some more animals. I live in a very rural place. I woke up one morning, there was a huge bear print in my yard, and also a bunch of deer hoof prints and some looked like coyote prints, and there was some kind of menagerie going on out there. I think that's the right use of that word. No, a menagerie is specifically like a collection of animals or something, isn't it? That like somebody has collected, it's like royal courts collected exotic animals, and that was a menagerie, so that's probably not the right use of this word. It was a council, I think, that they were meeting, plotting the overthrow of humanity, which kind of ties into what I was saying about the groundhogs, maybe. I don't know if we deserve a place at that council, but maybe we should have one if we can take a place at the council. Then all will be solved. Or not. I should not talk as much between songs. I apologize. I should just play my songs and not try to make vague political or spiritual statements.
They're nice.
Well, thank you. You didn't have to say that. Now I feel like I fished for that compliment. All right.
I meant it.
Thank you. for coming out here. And thank you to Catsy Pine. That was quite wonderful. And thank you to Ox Meadows. This just all seems very perfunctory. I apologize. I really did appreciate that music. I thought it was quite good. And I always have to remember before I get done playing to say something about it. And thank you to the Beauty Supply Arts. Is that what this place is? I have maybe one more song, maybe two, if you don't hate me by the time this one's done, or if it hasn't gone on for too long. All right, I'll just do one more. So that was a very unenthusiastic silence of spoke words, I think. Thank you, my friend Mike Mannix here, for kind of putting me in touch with, I think Mike had a hand in setting this show up too. That's who I reached out to. Because Mike lived in Nashville for several years and we connected there. And now here we are. Thank you, Mike. And I have an album over there, and it's not good business for me to say it doesn't really sound like anything I'm playing right now, but it is a good album. I'm proud of it, and Mike brought some copies of it here. It's not quite out yet, and this is the first time I've had it in my hands to look at, and I think it looks quite nice and sounds quite nice. And there are some of those back there and some other records too. If you want anything, you can talk to me about it. And also, I'd like to thank myself and pat myself on the back. That's what Dee Dee Ramone said, I think, when the Ramones were inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. You'd think he was my favorite Ramone. I really like Dee Dee. Anyway, this is just some meandering horseshit. I don't know what it is. it for me. Thank you, everybody.